Joseph. From 8 December 2020 to 8 December 2021, to mark the 150th anniversary of Blessed Pope Pius IX's declaration of Saint Joseph as the patron of the Universal Church. The way of the cross, which we will spiritually trace this evening, invites all of us, particularly families, to contemplate Christ crucified in order to have the force to overcome difficulties. Once more, in meditation, prayer and song, we will recall Jesus' journey along the way of the cross, a journey seemingly hopeless, yet one that changed human life and history, and opened the way to new heavens and a new earth. The experience of suffering and of the cross touches all mankind. It touches the family too. How often does the journey become wearisome and difficult? The cross of Christ is the supreme sign of God's love for every man and woman, the superabundant response to every person's need for love. At times of trouble, when our families have faced pain and adversity, and especially during this time of the pandemic, let us look to Christ's cross. There we can find the courage and strength to press on. There we can repeat with firm hope the words of St. Paul in the letter to the Romans. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. In times of trial and tribulation, we are not alone. The family is not alone. Jesus is present with His love. He sustains them by His grace and grants the strength needed to carry on, to make sacrifices, and to overcome every obstacle. And it is to this love of Christ that we must turn when human turmoil and difficulties threaten the unity of our lives and our families. And so let us stand as we begin with our
to the pressure of the accusers, and thus the Nazarene is condemned to death. It seems we can hear you say, Lord, I have been condemned to death. So many people who seem to love and understand me have listened to the lies and accused me. They did not understand my words. They handed me over to judgment and condemnation, to death by crucifixion, the most ignominious death. More than a few of our families suffered because of betrayal by a spouse, a person we hold dearest. Whatever became of the joy of being close, of living in unison? What happened to the sense of being completely one? What became of the words from this day forward which were once spoken?
Jesus falls. These wounds
Mary is the model of that silence, which even in moments of profound pain gives birth to new life.
And trying to ease their suffering. Receive us as at last the land of your land. One who made the same land that is now almost very great. You seem to have overthrown long straight gate to the present new day. And so you fall.
We recognize our sovereignty, Jesus, even in this early exhaustion fall. Yet get up again, you want to carry on. For us, for all of us, give us the courage to get up again. We are weak in need, but your love is greater than our failures. It is always need to accept and understand.
Mm-hmm. after weary to us need, and take up a new journey to go over. So many brothers and sisters throughout the world are enduring tremendous trials because they don't believe Jesus. Thereby, we need to get away, and we need to also fall beneath persecutions, which for 2,000 years have been inflicted on your body, which is church.
Love. It is the law of love that leads us to give our our own lives for the good of others. We see this in our mothers who face even death in order to bring their children into the world, or parents who have lost a child in war or in acts of terrorism, yet choose not to seek revenge.
Let me share.
mother of the Son, and the Son of his mother, to John and to us. Jesus and Mary, here is the family that undoubtedly suffers and experiences the often separation. Death parts them, or at least it seems to part them. A mother and son, united by an unbearable bond, both human and divine. Out of love, they celebrate. Both abandon themselves to the will of God. Into the chasm, opening the Mary's heart, comes another son, one who represents the whole human race. Mary's love for each of us is a prolongation of the love for Jesus. In Jesus' disciples, she will see his face, and she will live for them, to sustain them, to help them, to encourage them, and to help them to acknowledge the love of God, so that they may turn into the God.
Participation in the work of the cross, we may now be seated as we prepare for the Holy Mass.